The topic is regarding the population. Population, which is a major concern not only for India but many other countries like China, Brazil and other developing countries also. And every country followed their own method, own style of reducing the population. Essentially, see, if you take population, the population of any country depends upon natural factors as well as human factors. For example, see, birth rate is a natural factor, means in that country, because of more children being born, population increases. Similarly, death rate, in a country, if deaths are more, population falls down. This is natural. Whereas emigration is different. Immigration means people coming into the country. For example, in countries like USA, people frequently come from other countries to USA. Because of that, their population grows. In some countries, emigration means people going out of the country. For example, let us say, take Syria. In Syria, because of civil war, several people are going out of Syria in search of a better life, due to which the population of Syria falls down. You understand? So population depends upon both natural factors as well as the migration factors. Generally, if you want to control the population, first of all, you have to feel or think that population is a major problem. In some countries, population is not a major problem. But in few countries like India or China, population is thought to be a major problem. For example, in India, you know that we take census every 10 years, right? As per 1951 census, the population of India was 35 crores. Whereas, according to 2011 census, our population almost 121 crore population. So there's a huge jump, a very fast increase of population in India. Because of this population, there is a pressure in every sector. For example, in social sector, in social development, pressure is there. Because as people are increasing, the amount of number of schools, number of hospitals will not be sufficient. The welfare measures of the government will become very expensive. Government has to spend a lot of money for welfare measures. So social development will definitely be hampered because of huge population growth. Similarly, the economic development of the country will also be affected, because the resources, mineral resources or water resources, or the amount of land for agriculture, understand, any resource will be limited. We cannot increase the land for agriculture, we cannot increase the minerals of India for people. So similar employment also, we cannot create so much of employment. There will be limit for economic sector. So hence, economic development is also affected by huge population growth. Not only these two, even environment will be affected, because the number of trees or water or atmosphere air will be affected if the population increases. For example, the air pollution, of course, air pollution may be because of not using the right technology for transportation, whatever. But still, population also a major factor. Because of huge population increase in the vehicles, the traffic, it leads to air pollution, which leads to water pollution, land pollution, which leads to deforestation also. Increase in the population is one of the factors for deforestation. Thus, the increased population has effect in all dimensions. See, when we study sustainable development, generally we see that sustainable development is when the social, economic and environmental, social development, economic development and environmental conservation, when all the three go hand in hand and all the three are there, only then we call it as sustainable development. Now, because of population, all the three are affected. All the social development, economic development, environmental conservation, all affected by the population. Hence, the increase means rapid population. We call it as population explosion. It's too much increase in population, 35 to 121. unbelievable increase in population. Because of that, definitely it is affecting the sustainable development of India. But some of us may think that because population increased so much, now we are thinking about population. No. Even 1951 also, at the time also, almost I think in 1952 itself, at the time, when Nehru was Prime Minister, at the time itself, the Planning Commission thought about the problem of population in India, and we have formulated certain policies, we have taken certain measures to control the population. In fact, India is the first country in the world, in the entire world, India is the first country to take measures to control population. During the time, no country took specific measures to control the population, no country took. India has taken. See, even though we have taken, see the population growth. That means our measures, either those measures are not in the right direction, or though the government has intention to control population, people did not support with the government measures. That is also possible. See, any policy can be successful if the policy can be taken by the government into the people. When people accept their policy, when people by themselves follow the policy. See, government implementing policy is one thing, people understanding, accepting the policy and following it is a different thing. For example, anti-dowry is there, or child marriage act is there. Child marriage, okay, people, this is accepting it. Many people are not marrying in the childhood, I mean before 18 years of age. However, the dowry, even if government has an act, dowry, anti-dowry act, still people take dowry, right? Which means acceptance is not there among the people, though government has a policy. Similarly, though the population, government has a policy, many people think that my children, my wish, I can get 10 children, it's my wish. Depending on my interest, my family interest, my religious interest, cultural reasons, or what reasons. For example, I have a agricultural field of 10 acres. If I want to bring outside people, I have to pay. If I have 10 sons, they only will take an agriculture, right? But here, long-term thinking is a problem. If you think in the long term, these 10 sons, daughters, whoever, will divide 10 acres into 1 acre. And again, if they get 10 sons, one tenth of acre. You cannot do agriculture, you cannot even stand on the acre, understand? So, now, here we should understand what are, first of all, we should understand why the population of India is growing so fast. What are the reasons? Only when you understand the right reasons, you can formulate a right policy, you can address it through a right act, okay? Now, let us see what are the major reasons for such a explosion of population, rapid increase in population. For example, only when you know the reasons for population growth, you can take measures to control it. You know, little treatment. If you want to treat a disease, you should know reasons of disease. You cannot just treat the symptoms of disease, you have to treat the root cause of disease. Like that, see, for example, I want to control population. Directly, what I'll think? Sterilization. Sterilize everybody. Everybody means who is married, have some 2 children, you sterilize them. For example, do you know, in 1976, when India has, in 1976, there was a national population policy for India. At the time, government thought that sterilization is the best method. By sterilizing, you can reduce the number of children. Okay, male sterilization and female sterilization. Okay, both. At the time, in Congress government, certain people who do not have the human values, ethics, whatever, they started male sterilization forcefully. You know, forceful coercive, we call it as coercive sterilization. When somebody is running, catch him and do sterilization. Not in that way, but thing is, coercive sterilization has been done during that time. Means actually that was emergency time. During emergency, the entire country is in the hands of the government. Government has good control over the country. So at the time, they have done the coercive sterilization. Now they cannot do that. Okay? So because of coercive sterilization, what happened, you know? Because of coercive sterilization, what happened, you know? Unfortunately, some males who are not married, unmarried also, they are sterilized. Okay? Anyhow, now because of that reason, people generally have a negative opinion about government's population measures. See, one bad step taken by the government has made the people lose trust on the government or population. So now whenever government comes up with a new population policy, people are not accepting it. their acceptance has fallen down because of this step. Anyhow, let's come for reasons, okay? And we should also discuss what are the various steps already taken by the government. Essentially, any topic you have to discuss what are the reasons, steps taken by government, what else shall you take? Or maybe you discuss some international examples. Generally, whenever you're talking about any issue of India, you should compare that issue with other countries. Only then you can get the broad view. You should not look into only India, okay? You should look into other countries which are facing the similar problems, what steps they have taken, and because of those steps, what problems they have got, okay? For example, see, the major reasons for population, for explosive population, population explosion, rapid growth is
waiting for service.
What is that? That is also correct only. I'll let that correct point actually. See, one is illiteracy. Illiteracy. Particularly illiteracy means both male and female literacy. Means generally illiterate people do not know the importance of small family. Okay, illiterate people generally follow the traditions, or the my grandfather has 8 sons, my father 10 sons, children, I will have 12 children. Some people even feel it as a pride. The point is, illiterate people always follow the old practices. They do not understand the importance of small families. Particularly, illiteracy of female is very important here. Because, see, of course, in most of the families, the decision of number of children are taken by the male only. Female has no right. Female has only right to carry children. Means in the villages or whatever. But now, as you literate the female, as females get educated, then they can have the self, they can have the sufficient control over the family, and they can in fact argue that they want 2 children. If they want more children, the male can, among with himself, he can produce. Okay, so illiteracy of the female is identified as a major problem here. Illiteracy. Second thing, like how you said, actually the point you said is from Economic Survey 2017-18. Economic Survey of India 2017-18 actually said that, actually we call it as unwanted children. Do you know unwanted children? For example, I want a son. First attempt, I got daughter. Second, again daughter. Third, again daughter. I will wait for the son. 30 daughters, still finally I got a son. Now I got son, now I'll stop. So here, these 30 daughters are unwanted children. I have just produced them looking for a son. Understand? So looking for a son, whomever you produce, they're all unwanted children, okay? So this is one of the reasons people say is for population growth in India, population growth. But these people are at least better than those people who do female feticide. At least they are producing the girls. But some people, till they get the male boy, they'll keep on killing the girls either in the womb, female feticide, or the young girl, female infanticide. Feticide means killing in the womb. Infanticide means killing after the birth of the child. So these people are better than these people. Anyhow, this is one of the reasons for population growth in India. Then poverty is a main reason, poverty. Do you know poor people think children are resources? More children you get, they will take care of you later on. But they do not know, first of all, they have to take care of the children now for next 20 years. That they do not know. Of course, in the Indian villages, olden days, there is a thought that God will take care of children. It is the God who is giving children, he will take care. In some families do not know how children grow. They'll keep on taking birth, many children, they'll grow themselves. Even they do not know how they grow. Understand? So that's the situation. Actually, poverty is one of the major reasons. In fact, even Karl Marx in the communism, Karl Marx says that poor people, see, for example, what are the various factors of production? The various factors of production are land, I'm talking economics, not this production. Land, labor, capital. Yeah, technology also you can write actually. Entrepreneurship. Okay, technology you can write. Raw material you can write. However, these 4 are considered to be the major factors of production. In this factor, a rich person will produce more land. He will control more land. Capital, he will control capital. He will be entrepreneur. And poor person, he cannot produce, take more land, more capital, entrepreneur. So he will produce more labor, that means children. Actually, Karl Marx and communism says that poverty is the reason for huge population. communism. But this principle is correct only. Correct. Okay. So poverty is another reason for population growth, high population growth. Four is, see, this as of once upon a time, the main reason is no accessibility to contraceptives. Accessibility to contraceptives. And also early marriages. See, if you see, accessibility to contraceptives means, see, accessibility to the condoms, both male condoms and female condoms. Frankly, once upon a time, the accessibility is very low in India. You have to go to a big medical store somewhere in the city. But nowadays, they are sold everywhere, in petrol bunks also. Okay? So, this problem actually is addressed by government. Government addressed this problem long time back. Of course, right from the first five-year plan, government is trying to control population. In several five-year plans, they have taken several steps. However, this is one of the steps government is continuously taking, contraceptives. For example, even copper tea. For example, condom you can use only once. But copper tea, once you take, you can use it forever. So copper tea is also encouraged by certain government hospitals in India. Copper tea, okay? So this step is already taken very well. Now, early marriages, or you can call child marriages. See, regarding this, you should know one thing. In 1929, in the British India, there was an act by the British government. Actually, though colonial government is ruthless and it has it is a major reason for economic undevelopment of India, they have taken some good steps, some good acts they have taken. Of course, those acts have been taken because of force from the great Indian social reformers. For example, William Bentinck has taken anti-sati act was passed, but that was because of force from Raja Ram Mohan Roy and all. Similarly, widow remarriage act is passed. It's a good act. That is because of force from the Ishwar Vidyasagar and some other socio-religious reformers. Similarly, in 1929, child marriage act means abolition of child marriage in India. It's a good step taken, good act passed by British government of India. But according to that act, child marriage means, as per 1929 act, for a girl 14 years is considered child. If she cross 14 years, she can marry. For a boy, 18 years. More than 18 years, you can marry. But this age was based upon the tradition at that time. Because at that time, they used to marry girls at the age of 9 years, 8 years, like that. 9, 8 years, okay? So, directly 9 to 19 means they will not agree. Any act you pass should be reasonably followed by the people. No? For example, right now, I am marrying my daughter 9 years, yes. Suddenly, she's 18 years. I cannot wait till then. That's why 14 years. Males also. I think even Gandhi also is married at 16 years. Gandhiji.
17.
17, huh? Very good. 17 years. So point here is, so at that time the tradition is like that. Tradition. That's why they kept 18 years as the age. And 18 years. Gandhi married before this only. So Gandhi followed the law. Okay. So the point is now again in 1976, the age has been, as per the new population policy, I told you, 1976 population policy. According to that, the ages have been increased. Now for the female, it is 18, male 21. So if any of our friends, boys, marrying at 20 years, they come under the Child Marriage Act. 20 years, boy should not marry. 21, girl 18 years. But see, actually 21, 18 is also not a good number. 18 is very young, in fact, because a girl to get to do intermediate graduation, post graduation, at least 24 years should be there for a girl to marry. Okay, so but you cannot say 24 directly, because within the rural India already they are marrying at age of 15, 16, 17. Suddenly 24 is difficult now. That's why they kept 18. Now what government is doing is, though they limit the age at 18, government is encouraging for late marriages. That is very important step. Encouraging for late marriages. Tell me, how do you encourage somebody for late marriage? For example, for the graduation, you give scholarship to girls. They will do graduation at least for scholarship. For post graduation, provide complete free education for all girls for post graduation. Then they will do post graduation. Understand? And any girl who marries after 21 years of age, for that marriage, you give her 50,000 rupees. Some state governments give 50,000 rupees for girls who marry after 21 years. So like that you encourage them. As per that, 18 years only for the girls. But through the government policies, you encourage them. See, act is something which if you do not follow, you will be punished. Punishment will be there. Okay? But policy is something, means the incentive, means the policy is something by which you provide incentives to do the good things. For example, if you marry after 21 years, I'll give you incentive. Otherwise, no incentive, that's all. Means no punishment. Understand? That's the difference. So right now, 18 years is okay. At 18 years, you can get married. No legal action will be taken against you. But if you marry after 21 years, you will get incentive, either scholarship or some government will give some money, fund something. Understand? Similarly, see, I'll tell you some of the incentives. For example, certain state governments have, because here the point is, any couple should not have more than 2 children. But you cannot put a law. Only 2 children. If 3rd child is born, you will punish it. You cannot say that. If you say that, for example, I have 1st daughter. 2nd, I got twins, son and daughter. What shall I do? You understand? So basically, you cannot put an act and you cannot punish them. The point is, if you want everybody to produce only 2 children, the best thing is, you tell them that for the first 2 children, government will give 20,000 each. Matritva Sahyog Yojana. Something, some Yojana. Okay? 3rd children, you do not give money. Something like that. Means you encourage all 2 children, but you don't punish anybody for 3 children. Because already punishment. See, anything, for example, producing, reproductive right is a right. I will produce how many children I want. For example, I have 10 crores. I have 10 companies. I want 10 children. Each child can take 1 company. 1 child cannot take care. I feel like that. It's my reproductive right. My means women, men, both of them. Reproductive right. So you cannot coerce, means you cannot punish them for producing children. So through incentives, policies, that way you measure. So even nowadays, if you see many state governments, for first 2 children, they provide for intermediate and graduation, they give 6 months scholarship. 3rd child, they will not give. Understand? Of course, there are some people in India who do not have good idea about society. They say that if there is a 3rd child, the 3rd child should not get the voting right. She should not get any kind of facilities in India. Those kind of things. They are very harmful. You should never be forcing somebody to do something. You should never punish anybody. Only incentive or keep quiet, that's all. Okay? Do you know who said that? A 3rd person should not vote. Means any 3rd child should not get the voting rights. You see who said that. Okay? Anyhow. Now, second thing is, early marriage is other reason. Early my other reason for because when a woman is married at a very young age or male at very young age, she'll have one thing is they will not be matured enough to take correct decisions. Okay, after marriage, keep on producing children, but once they get 24, 20, 26, they have that maturity to take good decisions. That's why child marriage, one reason. Second reason is early marriages are actually harmful for health also. Health, they affect the health. Give me a remote, yes, remote, they are harmful for health also. Do you know many women who married 17, 16, 18, there is a more chance of maternal mortality rates. Now here, the next point I want to say is maternal mortality rate, child mortality rate, infant mortality rate, neonatal mortality rate. These are important reasons. Do you know why in olden days or in villages, many couples, they want to produce at least some 7 to 8 children for safety? Because anyhow 2 children will die. If you ask your grandparents or parents, grandparents, you ask them how many children they have, definitely out of 10 children, 2 or 3 would have died in the very early age, young age, something. So if I produce only 2 children, both of them die, I will not have children now. So for safety, produce some 4 more, 6, 7 children. One person will die at below 1 year, one person will die at 3 years. So the remaining will be available now. Understand? So with that safety thinking also, many couples used to produce more children. That is why if you want to reduce the number of children produced by a couple, you have to reduce the deaths of children. So here neonatal mortality rate means death of a newborn child in less than 4 weeks. 4 weeks means 0 to 27 days, 28 days you can write if you want. 0-27 days, 4 weeks. 4 weeks is the, within 4 weeks anybody dies, it comes under neonatal mortality rate. See, you will count number of deaths per 1000 live births. Here, you will count for 1000 live birth. Means, among 1000 birth, among 1000 children, how many died in less than 4 weeks, within 4 weeks. It's called neonatal mortality rate. Infant mortality rate means death of any child under the age of 1 year. Under the age of 1 year. Till 1 year, you call it as infant. Infant mortality rate. Similarly, child mortality rate means below 5 years. Till 5 years, you call it as child. Of course, according to the criminal laws and all, child means 18 years. But for this calculation, 5 years. Till 18 years, you cannot measure. Okay. So, child mortality means 5 years. Maternal is different. Actually, maternal mortality rate means death of mother, woman, either when she is pregnant or after delivery up to 42 days. Generally, you measure up to 42 days. Because the reason why 42 days is because genital tract infection occurs mostly to men. Genital tract infection. This infection generally because of rupture of the tracts, it generally occurs, it will stay till 42nd day after pregnancy also. So, right from the time of pregnancy to 42 days after delivery, you count it as maternal mortality rate. But remember, maternal mortality rate is not counted for 1000 births, it's counted for 1 lakh births. Only maternal mortality rate is counted for 1 lakh births, okay? Out of 1 lakh pregnant women or live births, how many mothers died? Women died, okay? So, if you can reduce this neonatal mortality rate, infant or child mortality, if you can reduce this children, death of children, if you can reduce, then the couple will get confidence that okay, there is safety for children. Then they can stop at 2 children or 3 children. That is also one reason. You should understand. Did you see? Many people think that contraceptive, sales contraceptive? Here. Contraceptive and you know that, sterilization. Contraceptive and sterilization. Many people think only these two things. One thing, you should use contraceptive. Second thing, after 2 children, you have to sterilize them. Sterilize, that's all. Means, that is called superficial thinking. You are thinking only at the symptoms, means the final thing. But you have to go to the root cause of the problem and solve it. For that, you should look into all these things. Early marriages, poverty, this the mentality of male, wanting the male. Actually, see, male domination, male predominance, or importance given to the male child. There is a very important reason. Now here, but to address this problem, it's not easy. It's not so easy to address the problem of male child. For example, I know that in this class, 80% of people, though they prepare for UPSC, become IAS officers also, still they want a male child only. What is the reason? The reason why everybody wants a male child is because, I told you yesterday, female child has certain problems in India. One, safety is a problem for females. Male, generally safety is not a big problem, males. First one is safety. Second thing, dowry. Dowry is a problem. Third thing is employment. Generally, man means he can get employed easily, he can go doing business anywhere, he can go into politics, he can do work, whatever, he can earn some money. Four, females go away from you. The basic system of India, most parts of India, the females marry somebody, they give you. And in fact, after that, they give importance to the husband, mother-in-law, then the parents. Where a son will bring the wife to the house, understand? So, these are the 4 to 5 factors. So, if these 4 to 5 factors are changed, definitely this mentality will change. As of now, it's changing already. First thing, if safety is taken care of, okay? Means instead of male attacking female, if females are attacking male mostly, slowly this will change, perception, first thing. Second, dowry. Dowry, right now, males are taking. Slowly females start taking, again it will change perception. You have to basically stop dowry. Female taking is also wrong only. I am just joking, okay? Now don't start taking dowry. Now, what third thing? What is it? One is safety. Second, dowry. Third is employment. If more women are employed than males in business, in more women in politics, in businesses, entrepreneurs, in softwares, in everything, then the people in India, as they see women working everywhere, women become powerful, they want a daughter. Right now, because males are powerful, they want a son. Simple. It's a mindset. And finally, what else I said? women leaving, male coming. So from nowadays, women after marrying the male, they have to bring the male to their home. So that slowly what happens is, after a few years, the parents will say, okay, if I have a girl child, man will come and we'll stay together. Man child means male child will go away, he'll leave me. That feeling has to slowly be created, understand? So basically it's a mindset. You cannot scold poor illiterate people for wanting a male child. They have their own reasons. You try to change the society, then their mindset will change. Okay, so that is another reason for unwanted child, because of which population is growing. Okay, now see, generally in the examinations, UPSC examination, whatever, you should be able to use these ratios, numbers, recent numbers, current affairs. For example, presently the child mortality rate, see, for example, the child mortality rate of India is 39. Means 39 children out of 1000 live births are dying within 5 years, 39. And we are aiming to bring it to 30. One of our aims is to bring it to 30, to reduce it, okay? We are trying for it. Fortunately, the global average of child mortality rate is also 39 only. So India is matching with the global average of child mortality rate. However, if you see the infant mortality, can anybody tell me whether infant mortality is more than child mortality, less than child mortality?
Less than child.
Why?
Child will remember 5 years.
5 years, exactly. Exactly. Actually, if anybody dies within 1 year, they will be counted here also. If anybody dies in 1 year, they will be counted 5 years also, no? Understand? So, CM, child mortality is a broad thing. Within that, neonatal is a subset. See, neonatal mortality. Infant mortality contains neonatal mortality also. Child mortality contains these two, because up to 5 years now. That's why 39, this is, I think,
32.
How do you know? This is 24. As per 2017, the time, the neonatal mortality rate of India is 24 deaths within 4 weeks. Infant mortality rate 32 within 1 year. Child mortality 39 within 5 years, nearly, in about 2017 census. 2017 statistics. Okay? But if you see, 39 is a global average, not a problem. But 32 is more than global average. The global average of infant mortality, global average is 29. That means we are worse than the global average. Understand? Here also, this 24, no, I think it is some 18. Neonatal mortality global average is 18 only, but here it is 24, very poor. So child mortality, though we are reasonably good, infant neonatal very, very poor, we have to work on that. Okay, see, even other reason is technology or institutional delivery. I'll come to that anyhow. Here let us first finish this one. So here according to the sustainable development goals, see, 2010 to 2015 we have millennium development goals, which every country tried to follow. Actually, millennium development goals means the goals formulated by the entire world. United Nations help is there in that. So according to that, what are the targets we have to meet regarding the health, education, this population, or mortality rates, or environment? Many targets are there. One homework for today is, today you go home, you make a list of sustainable development goals from website, try to understand them so that you can use them in every answer. Generally, sustainable goals, there are 17 sustainable goals. Every goal can be used in some question of UPSC. If it is regarding environment, you can use some goal. Children, you can use one goal. Health, you can use one goal. Women, you can use one goal. Understand? Sustainable development goals. I will take, actually this will be dealt in the economics class. Sustainable development goals is from 2015 to 2030. 15 to 30. Within this 15 years, what are the various targets for every country in this world? Okay. So we have to follow those targets also in this mortality rates. Okay. Now, if we look at the maternal mortality rate per 1 lakh births, we count maternal mortality rate. Presently, I think as per 2018 statistics or 7 statistics, 122 women out of 1 lakh births, 122 women are dying. which is a very big number. And our target is to reach 100 within next 5 years. 100. We have reached 100. 100 MMR, maternal mortality ratio or rate. Okay. So these are the various things which you can actually you can use this in many answers of UPSC examination. Okay. Anyhow, coming to the next point, other reason for the population growth explosion of India is that technology. See, actually sterilization is leading to death of the male or female, definitely referred to sterilization. Do you know in some villages either male or female, take female for example, because generally sterilization mostly females will undergo in India. That is also because of male domination. You should know vasectomy and tubectomy. Vasectomy is taken by male, tubectomy by female. These are the sterilization techniques of sterilization methods, male and female. Generally in India, out of 100 sterilization, only some 5 to 10 will be male vasectomy, 90 will be female tubectomy only. Because there also, because of male domination, women are undertaking sterilization. Frankly, vasectomy is very easy than tubectomy, very easy. But still males are afraid, because male feels that if they do vasectomy, tomorrow due to some reasons, if they want again produce children, they cannot produce children. Male, in India, male feel that if they don't have that fertility, they feel not as a male itself. The feeling is there, understand? But actually that is different, children is different. That you learn yourself, okay? Anyhow, then, so recently in Jharkhand, one particular doctor has done almost, I don't know, maybe 135 tubectomies he has done a single day. He has given award also. So tubectomy single day he has done. After that found that most of them died. Why? Because he used the infected syringes, same things. Means he has not done it using the proper protocol, proper in sterile methods, in sterile environment he has not done it. Okay. So because of these kind of incidents, now women are not coming forward for sterilization. They are not coming. They are saying that if you want, we will stop producing children, but don't have sterilization. They're afraid. So technology also a major problem, and institutional delivery is a major problem. Institutional delivery, or you can say delivery by the trained people. Actually, institutional delivery means delivering the children in hospitals, in primary health care units or hospitals with trained people. Okay, you cannot go to hospital because it became urgent. At least a trained person should be there in every village, every panchayat village, who has to come and deliver the child in the home itself. Okay, actually one India's aim is that 80% should be institutional deliveries, 100% should be trained deliveries, I mean delivery by trained people. Okay, so 80% should be institutional deliveries target, but as of now we could not reach target. But Kerala, Tamil Nadu are doing very well. Remember, Kerala, Tamil Nadu will do very well in every aspect, health, education, women empowerment, everything. Generally the states are like that, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Kerala because of communist government, Tamil Nadu because of regional political parties from a long time, political parties, okay? And educated leaders. Always with Tamil Nadu, right from the first time, Tamil Nadu right from the beginning days, all the politicians of Tamil Nadu, highly educated politicians, good social workers, became chief ministers. That's why it became like the state. Kerala, communist. Communist means basically, I'm not saying communist best for the government, definitely every form of government best for government, but communist generally takes more care of people than capitalist or money. Okay, anyhow, keeping that aside, because in India, institutional deliveries are less in number. In many places, there won't be hospital nearby also. Sometimes you see, there was an article in newspaper where women almost is delivering, almost the baby is coming out, but she's holding and going to hospital. Because there is no trained person nearby, there is no nearby hospitals, understand? And many people in India die on the path to hospital. Generally, most deliveries happen naturally, no need of any trained person. But some deliveries become difficult. There you have to turn the baby, take the baby out, you know, some things are required. At that time, an untrained person cannot do anything, you have to go to hospital. But if the hospital is 30 kilometers away, while going to hospital, either baby will come out, or the mother will die, anything can happen, okay? So that's another reason for why the mortality is increasing, because of which population is increasing, because of they want to produce more children, you understand? Actually, generally what we think? We think that, okay, because of these reasons, people will produce less children. No, because of these reasons, people will produce more children, because no guarantee of having a live baby, right? You understand? Anyhow, I want to stop it here because somewhere I have to stop now. That's why I'm stopping it here. See, these are the reasons. But frankly, if you want to study reasons, you want to do PhD, you can make some thousand reasons. But we are not here to do PhD. We are here to just identify 5-6 important factors and move on. Okay? But if you have some other reasons also, tell me after the class. Because now I have to cover these things also. Okay? Anyhow, now I'm coming to government, steps taken by government. Let us discuss the steps taken by government. See, any examination, particularly UPS examination or any government examination, right? You should not write only reasons and your ideas, no. Write something done by government also. Write at least few things done by government. Even if they did not ask you also, still write that government has taken these steps, these policies, these acts, these laws, this constitution, whatever, you mention some things. Generally, any government examination, you have to, as you want to go into the system of government, you should know what government is doing in this regard. You have to mention few things and then you write your own suggestions. But while writing suggestions, do not criticize the government too much. Just say that government could have done that, it can be done in that way, like that. Because you are not a journalist, writing newspaper, where criticizing the government very harshly. You should not do that. Criticize so much, they will not give marks, okay? Be neutral. Provide a constructive criticism, not a outright, blatant, irrational criticism should not be made. Actually, you have to make like this as a journalist, but as a UPS aspirant, you have to make constructive criticism. Means you have to say what government can do. Okay? Anyhow, now, if you look at the steps taken by government, as I told you, in 1952, already government has taken the measures to control the population, which is first in the world. No country has done that. That's why 35 to 121 we are able to achieve population. So 952, India is the only country to take the measures of population. Okay, then every 5-year plan we are doing something, but unsuccessfully, but doing something. Okay, for example, contraceptives we are able to provide everywhere. If you want, you can go, you can get anywhere. Okay, then sterilization we are able to successfully. Many villages, many doctors are able to sterilize many people. Okay, then you know, female education, we are not very successful, but okay, almost successful. Female education, as nowadays, particularly because of Article 21A of the Constitution of India, the 86th Constitutional Amendment Act of 2002. In 2002, 86th Constitutional Amendment Act and Article 21A, right, education, almost provide education to everybody. So now every girl is educated at least to the secondary level, if not tertiary, secondary education is able to go to, most of the girls. Kerala and Tamil Nadu, Kerala 100% literacy, female, 100% Kerala, okay? Then almost 100%, 99.some%, okay? Then even Mizoram also has very good female literacy, because, but that is the effect of Christian missionaries in the before independence, were there Northeast India. Because of that, they focus mostly on health and education. That's why. Even if you see Northeast India, they speak English, Mizoram, they speak English. Okay? They wear jeans, they play guitar, they have Western culture because of Christian missionaries. And they have almost gender equality is there among them. Okay? Then also see, for example, child marriages. Child marriages are prohibited. We have the Child Marriage Act. Government has done that. Child marriage prohibited. You can see in many places also, recently in Rajasthan, some other state, there was a marriage where a girl of 17 years, 16 years getting married, and they're attended by many child activists are there, women welfare organization, chairman is there, child welfare, everybody come to the marriage, okay? But that should not be done. Basically, if somebody is doing child marriage, you have to go and complain to the child organizations, women organizations. But the chairmen are there only, it will be easy for you to complain. Okay? Anyhow, so the problem is government is taking good steps actually, good steps. But somehow, somewhere, the implementation is lackadaisical, is a problem, implementation. But government is doing the right spirit. So implement is problem because of people actually, it's not government officials, people. Powerful people are forcing government officials not to follow the laws. A government official, if he wants to follow the law, people will just catch hold of him. They will not allow him to do it. Then what can he do? So problem with the people only, not government. Okay. Then 1976 national population policy, the coercive sterilization is there now, and increasing the child age to 18 years for female, 21 to male. That is done. Finally, in 1993 92 93 I think, M.S. Swaminathan is there, agriculture. He actually controls the crops. They asked him to control population also. M.S. Swaminathan is made the chairman of a committee. That committee is established to control the population of India. And they have made several recommendations. The recommendations accepted, I think, in 2000. In 2000, they made the National Population Policy 2000. According to this National Population Policy 2000, we have kept some targets ourselves. One target is that total fertility rate. You know what is total fertility rate? It is number of children that a woman produces in the span of her fertility. Every woman will have fertility from some 14 years something to 50 years, whatever, some age will be there. During that time, how many children she is producing on average? For example, let us say I am a woman, I am producing 10 children. You are also woman only. You are producing 8 children. You are producing 8, I am producing 10. What is the average? 9. But let us say I am producing 11. You are producing 8. What is the average?
12.
No. 11 and 8. Almost 9.5. 9.5. But what is 9.5? If I say 9.5 fertility rate, does that mean I produce 9.5 children? No, it's an average. Like that, total fertility rate of India, we are aiming to bring it to 2.1. Why 2.1? Why not 2? Because if you exactly produce 2 children, somebody dies in between, do accidents, whatever, it will fall down the population. We don't want it to fall down, we want to maintain. Okay, that is called as actually that maintaining the same population is called as population stabilization method rate. Population stabilization rate means you stabilize the population. Right now, population, see, as per 2011 census, it is 121 crore. Now, let us say easy 130 crore. According to my guess, 130. Okay, now you can see some websites, it will show population. You see, population of India. The numbers will keep on changing. Every second, 20 children, 30 children keep on changing. So website is there, you can see. Okay. The website also, they don't count. They kept it generally because anyhow, every 1 minute they are producing 20 children now. So no need to see it. We know India how it produces. Okay. The point is here, population stabilization rate means whatever 130 crores now, same 130 crore we have to maintain. Same. When will you maintain that? When two parents now, produce 2 children. After 2 years, they'll die. They'll continue. You understand? So it's called population replacement rate. Some you can call it as population stabilization rate, or you can call it as population replacement rate. Replacement is 130 crore people will die, again 130 crore people will be there, they'll born. They'll die again 130 crore. Stabilization, replacement. Okay. To achieve that one, actually our target is to achieve this population replacement rate by 2045. According to our population policy, 245. But now recently it's reviewed because we realized that 245 is not possible. 260. Now the new year is 260. Again, you wait till 250, they'll again increase it to 2080. Keep on increasing till we can, but one day we'll achieve it. Okay. So, generally when writing the questions on population, you have to use the words total fertility rate, population stabilization rate, population replacement rate. You have to use this kind of terminology. Understand? Anyhow, so not only this, government has taken many other steps also. For example, in the primary health centers, actually most deliveries in India happen by quacks, means not good, not untrained doctors. Okay. So in primary healthcare centers or auxiliary nursing midwives, ANMs. Auxiliary nursing midwives, ANMs, are kept in every PHC, every village, every panchayat, who will go spread awareness about awareness about nutrition. You know, a pregnant woman, if she does not follow right nutrition, there is a risk for both baby and mother also. And remember, in India, most villages where the male domination is there, even a pregnant woman has to eat the food after everybody eats. First husband will eat, then father-in-law, then mother-in-law, then some other person. Finally, the pregnant woman eats the food. So in many villages, what happens is, even the woman is pregnant, even then she is given the food at last. Last, what will be left, you know? After eating all chicken pieces, gravy is there now. The gravy she will eat. Anyhow, the point is, because of no proper nutrition, the MMR, CMR or whatever, all R's, because nutrition. That's why government is taking very good measures of nutrition. That's why government is giving, for for every pregnant as well as lactating mother, state governments provide 8,000 to 18,000 rupees per year during the pregnancy time, so that they can take good nutrition. So husbands who is alcoholic, if they know about the scheme, definitely they will access the scheme, because 8,000 rupees means you can almost 2 months of alcohol you can get. So government is taking many other steps like that. So here nutrition very important. Actually, I did not mention here nutrition is very important. Even government is giving in Anganwadis. You know, Anganwadis means free food for children. Not only for children, for adolescent girls also. Adolescent girls, government provides folic acid and iron tablet. A tablet having 4 dasic iron, you eat it. Okay, that is to maintain the nutrition of the girls from a very young age, so that they do not get any reproductive problems as they get married. That is also a step taken by government. Okay, then to control the population, one very important step to be taken is female empowerment, women empowerment. Actually, women empowerment is a broad thing. Whenever you don't know the correct answer, you read on women empowerment, because somehow it relates to every answer. So women empowerment actually is the best step to control the population. If women are getting educated, getting married at a very late age, getting settled in life, working with a good salary, then they will not listen to mother-in-law, father-in-law, any other-in-law. They will follow their own decisions, they will take decisions on their body. Actually, any woman controlling her own body is a basic right, but that is not given in many places in India, but there is a fundamental right in fact. Okay, reproductive right, right on her own, how many children she wants to have. Understand? Anyhow, so these are some steps government has taken. However,
in a case of NMR, hospital should be.
Yes, that is correct. Actually, do you know what government has done? Though government is able to increase the primary health care centers, they increased PHCs are not everywhere, they are unable to proportionately increase the personnel. Personnel means doctors, nurses, trained delivery people, whatever. Though you increase the number of hospitals, primary hospitals, you are unable to increase the doctors at the level. In India, there is a serious doctor shortage. Very short doctors. That's why some innovative ideas like, you know, if everybody cannot get MBBS, at least put a bachelor's degree. Bachelor in medicine, means not bachelor, some 3 years degree. So at least they can treat primary problems, not secondary problems, primary problems. Basically, it increases the number of doctors. See, because doctors are less in India and most doctors in cities, in villages, quacks, those who don't have any knowledge are coming and sitting and behaving like a doctor. And people have no option but to go to them. Okay, one more thing government actually is doing is, you know, Ayush, already traditionally India has a medical system, Ayurveda, Yoga, Unani, Siddhi, Homeopathy, as well as Naturopathy. N is not there, but Naturopathy. So these things are already there in India, no? Try to integrate them with the medicine. Of course, they both are slightly different. Generally, the allopathy doctors won't agree with them, and they always feel they are traditional and very powerful. However, we should integrate them. The reason is, only with the MBBS graduate doctors, we cannot treat all the patients, not possible. So better integrate them, make use of them, train them. If you want to train these people, Ayush people, train them in the latest treatment methods, whatever, along with their traditional methods. Okay, there's one thing which government is doing, and we have to do it in a better way. But remember, even today government is trying to solve this problem only at this two levels only. This has to be stopped. Government should work on other aspects, decrease the mortality rate, women empowerment, in fact, you know, in fact, reducing women violence also. If you want to reduce unwanted children, stop the dowry. Means at a major level, government has to take steps, and Child Marriage Act should be implemented properly, and Dowry Act implemented properly. Hospitals should have good infrastructure, good doctors, trained personnel should be there. Understand?
Hospitals should be constructed in well-ventilated.
Yes, yes. Basically, you have to write all those points in single point, that good hospital infrastructure and good personnel. That's all. Okay. Anyhow, in that way you can write. Now, you try to see, when you talk about the population, it's better if you compare some other countries. For example, you know, in Brazil, what they do? In Brazil, what they do is incentivize 2 children. Means third child will not get many things. For example, a family wants to have a ration card. They'll give that India has a pink ration card. No. White ration will be given to only those poor people who have 2 children. More 2 children, no ration card. and understand. For example, for example, China will come to China. Similarly, for example, if any family has to get tax exemption, tax. If anybody has to get no tax exemption, understand. So, of course, one way is punishing, but mostly it's not a legal punishment. It's mostly incentivizing. For example, if you have to come to in government school, if you want to get free education, you have to show to the government school that you have 2 children only. You have 3 children, no free education. You have to pay for the child. Understand? In that way, everything is linked to children. Every policy is linked to children. So that everybody will be producing only 2 children. Because if you want to access several government policies, schemes, welfare measures, you have 2 children only. That is something Brazil is doing very well. Actually, Brazil is able to achieve 2.1. This 2.1 able to achieve Brazil. China actually followed a slightly wrong strategy. China, I think in 1980s, China has taken this one child policy. That one child policy, let me tell you, recently India also few states, though there is no act, many people are having only one child, particularly the developed states. That is why in India also, we are facing the problem of aging population in some states. Actually, China, what happened, you know, from 1980 to 2015, almost some 25 years, they followed this 35 years, I think. Not 1980, 1978, 79, that time, almost 35 years, they followed one child policy. According to which, a strict one child policy. But see, though it is one child policy, I think it's a misnomer. Because within China, some minorities, some ethnicities are allowed to have 2 children. But broadly, one child policy followed. And they followed very rigidly, very coercively. Because what happened, you know, in China also, that male selection is there. Male child selection. That means everybody wants a male child, China also. So as because now government has put only one child, I will wait till the male child, till then female feticide. Actually, PCPNDT, you know, PCPNDT. Preconception, prenatal diagnostic techniques. Preconception, prenatal diagnostic techniques, PCPNDT. According to PCPNDT, actually what happened, you know, in India, you can easily find who is there in the, once you finish, I think, fifth month, from fifth month, you can identify who is a baby in the stomach, either male or female. And you know, sex selective abortions are done in India. But PCPNDT Act was formulated, so nobody in India allowed to go for identifying the sex of the child in the, sex of the baby in the womb, not allowed. But many doctors do that. They say that I am testing whether baby has diseases. For this is something they'll do. In that they'll find the sex and they will take some money from the parents. They'll tell the sex and parents will abort the female. It's called female feticide. Okay, female feticide is there in China also. Just there, because China government want one child, no? That one child I want male child. Why female child? Understand? So in that way also in China also that sex ratio. Sex ratio means number of females per 1,000 males. In Haryana, child sex ratio means within the 5 years of children, if it is all 5 years children in Haryana, out of almost 1,000 male, there are only 8, 30, 8, 40, 8, 20 females, very less females. So that means after 20 years, for 1,000 males, there will be 800 females only. So 200 males will go to Kerala for marriage. Why Kerala? Because Kerala has more females than males, Kerala, okay? So one child policy by China is very quick, because this policy problem is now, the problem is, the population is becoming half almost, not become half, almost. For example, 2 children, 2 parents, 1 child, no. So after that, only 1 child will be left. So later what happened is, old people will be more. After 30 years, all these parents will become old, no. Children will be young, no. So young children are 50% of old people. Old people, 100. Young people, 50. These 50 people will work in the companies, agriculture, whatever. They are to contribute for the revenue of the country. Old will sit in the home, they'll wait for pension, they'll wait for someone to take care of them. Understand? That will become difficult. Government has to give pension to 100 people, understand? Salary to 50 people. So the employable population very less. So hence, ultimately, what happens? The aging population becomes a big burden on the nation. Burden. This should not happen. Japan, same problem. Japan is different. Japan government did not follow any policy, one child policy and all. The Japanese people are like that. They don't want children. they generally busy in the work, they don't have time for children. Second thing is, they consider children as a kind of burden, whatever. After they get 50 years, 56 years, they try for children, they do not get at that time. So, Japan aging population, China aging population. So, in future, only India has all youthful population. That's why throughout the world, Russia has aging population only. So, India has a lot of young people. So, though we don't need employment here, you go to other countries. You work in China, work in Malaysia, Singapore, work in... So, India will be the labor supplier for the entire world tomorrow. However, India also recently in the 2009 economic survey, it is mentioned that in few states of India as of now, the chance of aging population is coming. After 30 years, some states like Kerala will have aging population only. Understand? So, that's why government do not want one child. There will be some slogans, no? For example, one father here, one mother here, one daughter here. In Telugu also, Muggur Muddu, basically. Okay. So, the point is, only one child. Means indirectly encouraging one child. So, one child, some people say is not a good idea. Two child is enough. So, what the population, present population is 121 million crore, right? Maintain the same thing. The thing. Anyhow, so, see, I have touched some of the important points of population. However, remember that population is a broad topic. If you get, as you study, read newspapers, get new ideas, you can add it. You basically take some 2 to 3 A4 sheets. For example, if you write these points in one A4 sheet, tomorrow as you get new points of population, you add them to the A4 sheet. The A4 sheet become maximum 2 A4 sheets only. Don't increase it like population, 30 A4 sheets. In UPSC, any topic, 1 or 2 A4 sheets only. You cannot maintain 30 A4 sheets each topic. Then the entire room will be filled with A4 sheets, you cannot revise it. Okay? Anyhow. See you.